Please, help me!
Yeah.
The Black Forest reigned here, its kingdom rarely invaded by those that live in the light. But it was called home by this mysterious Vorador. Legend told of a time when Vorador defeated Malek of the Seraphan. If such a man did exist, then he could perhaps be the key to defeating the Ward.
The blood of ages flows so sweet. Come, drink from us. Your strength has increased, for our blood enhances.
Shed your blood for me, and these artifacts will be yours.
Thank you.
This spell allows me to enslave my enemies, giving me control of their bodies. When I release my grip, their bodies will shrivel and die as I displace their souls and replace them with my own.
Yeah.
Allows me to use blood from my own body as a weapon. When struck, my enemy's blood would flow from their bodies to fill me with life. 'Tis a risk, yet the rewards are a temptation.
Oh, my God.
Stun. Stun.
Doctor!
Ravages flesh with teeth of metal and flame, leaving only scorched remains. Strange that Vorador would choose a dwelling so perilous to him. The swamp could only offer a vampire hazard and pain. Vorador's keep was hidden deep within the turbulent forest, nestled among vines and creepers that clung desperately to its dark, weathered stone. The luxury with which this Vorador surrounded himself was impressive. His wealth would shame the haughty nobles of my former court. That this vulgar display of fortune remained undisturbed was a testament of fear's dominion over greed. Their charms were almost visible through the gauze of their clothing, yet beauty such as theirs delivered only death. For these were Vorador's pets, nothing more than beasts, slave to his will and the easy prey he provided. Vampires, all of them, held in thrall by one stronger still. Control mind. Control mind.
They've picked us!
bone armor.
Lower forms of undead fall swiftly to deception. With the bone armor, they are not as eager to challenge me. Vorador's pantry, a vampire's feast. Like cattle awaiting slaughter, men and women dangled from the rusted hooks upon the dungeon walls. Blood and viscera frosted the dirt and stone. The abundance nearly overwhelmed me, for blood is the life. My enemies are quite vicious, and the Chaos Armor extracts from them a heavy price for their bloodlust. The blows are meant for me, but it is their bodies that carry the wounds.
Oh.
Blood of others. This spell is especially useful in the face of multiple combatants. Beware those with tainted blood. The room I had entered had but one purpose.
Oh, please.
The torture help, and execution of human beings for the sadistic pleasure of its engineer. Blood was splattered on every surface. The dread and agony of victims past still echoed through the lethal walls. A symphony of terror and agony filled the air. Then, from amidst the cacophony of screaming souls, came the perverse laughter of the vampire himself. Tapestries wove a tale of chaos ignited, an orgy of fire and pain. Undead beings with rotted skins caked with sulfur and ash beckoned at me through a burning abyss. Their tortured stares were a testimonial to the price of weakness. Their fate would not find me. Yet blood calls to blood. Amongst Vorador's possessions, I found an ancient chronicle. Long ago, vampires grew in such number so as to capture the attention of the Circle. The Order of the Sarafan, or the Angels of Light, as they were called, was instated to counter the menace. Thus, the vampire purge began.
In the bowels of that black forest, I found something worse than hell. A vision of what I was becoming.
It's not often I see one of our own, especially one as young and foolish as yourself. Nonetheless, drink. Drink deep and indulge your gift.
Gift? Vorador thought my curse a blessing. That we were gods. That mortals offered their blood as sacrifice so that we could enjoy our supernatural powers. And somewhere, deep inside my new self, I knew he was right. That mortal dreams were prayers. Prayers to us, begging us for power. I pondered this as the decadent old fool prattled on about his past. Boorish account of how he defeated Malek of the Seraphim and took his vengeance upon the Circle of Nine for supporting the Seraphim Holy War to exterminate us.
Dogs! They can feast on your corpses!
After slaughtering six of the sheep, I defeated their pathetic little shepherd, Malek. Since then, our kind has not bothered with the cattle, except to feed. And I suggest you do the same. Meddling with the affairs of man can do us no good. Seraphim witch hunts are much too tedious to concern ourselves with. Am I understood, Kain? Good. Take this ring. If you ever need assistance, it will summon you. Despite your youthful arrogance, you amuse me, Kain. It would be such a pity to lose you to the abyss. Now be gone!
With Vorador only strengthened my resolve. His power uncontested by mortals, he had fallen to another enemy. Decadence has claimed itself many a great warrior.